While Mason is known for its charitable actions and accomplished students, MHS takes a new spin on ways to donate money for pasta for pennies. Senior Connor McCormick and fellow NHS leaders created a Nerf Wars game that is known as Nerf Madness, a one-day tournament set up at the MI 45 gym that had teams battling it out for a great cause. Connor McCormick came together with a group of fellow NHS leaders to brainstorm a way for students to participate in a fun activity that would not only raise money for an organization that NHS has supported for years, but also bring students together in a way that hasn't been done before.
NHS came up with Nerf Madness because last year we did Knockout Cancer as a big new event. And so this year we weren't going to do Knockout Cancer again, so we were looking for a replacement event. So me, Carver Knab, Jackson Brown, Sam Wendell, and Dylan Bryan came to the advisors, Ms. Shuba, Ms. Messer, and Ms. Nimer, and said, hey, we think that this event called Nerf Madness could be really successful, and we think we could tie it into supporting the Leukemia Lymphoma Society. And it's like on a paintball field. It's on a basketball court, but we have like barriers that they use in like paintball or like laser craze, and we have those, and so you can run around and hide those and tag people with your Nerf blasters.
Some teams took this opportunity very seriously. Team captain Ethan Roser prepared his team with tactics and plays to win the tournament.
Well, you know, for the past couple of weeks, we've really been looking over tactics. We've been looking up websites and videos online and formations and how we can move as a team, you know, some simple sign signals and stuff to let each other know where they are. We've just really been practicing a lot, you know. It's all about the hard work, putting the sweat in, a lot of grit and determination.
This creative take on a way to raise money for a local charity helped students join this fun activity and brought smiles to their faces. I'm Maddie Young, NBC News.